Good morning, Chris Childers, Operations Section Chief with California Interagency Incident Management Team 1, and I'm also a local Santa Barbara County Battalion Chief, so I have a lot of home interest here. Let's talk about the Alisal fire. We're having some good luck. We've had a lot of hard work done by a lot of firefighters, and the aircraft has been a huge help. We've got 15 or more aircraft on the fire, including some that could drop at night, and so the last three nights we've been putting a lot of water on this fire, and therefore it's looking much better. So let's take a look. Quick trip around the fire on the map. Start at the top here. The point of origin is in Division Alpha. With fire burned the first night, as I've told you about it, very strong and hard to the east with a northwesterly wind flow. The next two nights, the wind came from the northeast and burned fire to the west, and that's how we got the fire so far towards Gaviota. Since then, we've been able to control the top on Camino Cielo with direct line and some firing, and then some direct hand line all the way around to the east side of the fire, where we tie into the younger fuels of the 5-year-old burn scar from the Sherpa fire. You notice we have direct line. It's very secure all the way around until it gets in the really steep country, so we have some unopened areas that we're going to be monitoring and keeping an eye on and trying to put people in as best we can safely. Then we have direct line around the bottom of the fire through Division Juliet, along the Pacific fuel break that we joke about because the Pacific Ocean has always held so far. And then we used 101 and it's completely cold, so that's why we were able to reopen the Highway 101 the other day. And you see we have some hand line and some direct dozer line constructed out towards Gaviota, all holding very well. Then we have it in the rocks and in the cliffs again, so we don't have it lined, but it's pretty much out in the rest of Division Lima. And as you see, we come up the hill to our last corner of heat, where we had some spot fires and some activity yesterday. This is old Decadent Fuels that hasn't burned since the 1955 fuel refugio fire, and so it's going to continue to have some heat in it, and it's not very clean burn, so it's going to be hot, but that's our concentration today. That's our priority number one. We're going to knock this out, and that should do a really good job of putting this fire to bed in the next couple of days, and I will keep you updated. So thank you for listening.